growing in our local community. You're the fastest growing demographic in our communities because we're living longer, but also I think, as hopefully a person that's still slightly on the youngish side in our society, actually valuing the role that you play, but also the experiences that you have and are able to share. I had the benefit a couple of weekends ago of actually sitting down with my grandfather, who still lives in Gunnedah, because that's where I'm from originally. And I actually spent half a day with him, actually just with an audio recorder, asking him about his past, his childhood, what he experienced, because he's been in poor health lately, and I'm absolutely terrified that when he goes, he will take all of that knowledge and wisdom with him, and I want to record it before he goes. And write it in a lot of our communities, a lot of our historical groups, a lot of our family history societies are going through exactly the same process. Why? Because I think it's really important that we capture the collective wisdom that each and every one of you have in our communities, so that that can be passed on to your children, to your grandchildren, and for some of you, your great-grandchildren. Because I think that's absolutely fascinating. Anyway, to each and every one of you, have a fantastic lunch. Great afternoon. I want to see you all up tearing up the dance floor after lunch, after you've got a bit of energy in your system. Some good lunch, I haven't seen any red cordial yet. There's some yellow stuff or orange cordial, whatever needs to be done, charge up on that and get out and have a great afternoon, because it's your time to have a bit of fun and have a good celebration. And for those of you that have travelled, have a very safe trip home. Thank you. Before we present these awards recognising some tremendous seniors in our local communities, I've been asked to do a quick shout out to four very special people. First of all, I don't have their Christian names here, but Mr. and Mrs. Mills are celebrating their golden wedding anniversary today. Where are you? Not correct. It is correct. You're shaking your head because you don't want to be married to him anymore, or years is enough. Okay, right. Anyway, congratulations. That is tremendous. And we've also got two people celebrating their 96th birthday today. Is anyone older than 96 in the room? They're probably not going to put up their hand. Okay. Norma from Boomba in Armidale is turning 96 today. Thank you so much. There's the Armidale group. Happy birthday, Norma, 96. And we've got Beryl Dallenberg. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Beryl. There you are. Thanks, Beryl. Congratulations.
Thank you, Adam. Now, the way we're going to do the awards is that Adam's going to read out the name of the person in the award, and then I'm going to ask Greg Lawrence here to read out a bit of a citation, a bit of information on why that person received that award. So I'd ask, when you do come up to receive your award, Adam's going to have to walk down the stairs and back up again. But could you, if you receive the award, could you stay around here for a group photograph, please? So I'll just ask Adam now to start the award presentation, please.
Thank you, Simon. Our first recipient of the Local Achievement Award Certificate for his outstanding service to the Guyra community as a volunteer driver. Congratulations, Darrell Taylor.
Darrell has been a volunteer for service for 8 years, delivering a community bus service from Guyra to Armidale on a fortnightly basis. Darrell spends an amount of time on his own delivering the service every Friday. He also volunteers to drive the bus for a regular monthly outing to places of interest for both the Home Support Service and Galera Hospital. Darrell has volunteered at the Guyra MPS, assisting to entertain the clients at special events. He shares his love for music and harmonica talents regularly with the wider community and through his involvement in the local church. Darrell is an invaluable member of our Home Support Transport team and supports the service, and the community is recognised.
Well done, Darren.
I'm feeling sorry for Adam, so save him from climbing up and down the stairs. I'll just put this microphone down here and represent anything from the floor.
Thanks, Adam.
Our next local achievement award certificate for his outstanding service to the Armidale community. Congratulations, Richard Mills.
Richard Mills is a foundation member of the Armidale Multiple Rotary Club, which was chartered in 1971, serving numerous terms as president and secretary while holding varied board responsibilities throughout his 45 years of membership. As an active member, he selflessly continues to devote his energy and activities for the benefit of Armidale community. He has been honoured as a Paul Harris Fellow in 1998. Mark was also honoured as a Paul Harris Fellow by the Armidale Royal Rotary Club in recognition of her community contribution by Rotary. This was a significant honour awarded to non-Rotarians. Congratulations.
Our next recipient for her outstanding service to the community, and I think a special award for being married to Richard for 50 years. Congratulations, Margaret Mills.
Margaret is an outstanding gardener and a tireless worker. It is recalled that when the new building known as the Leone Place was opened by Executive Rick and Margaret created the garden. For more than 40 years, Margaret used her abundant culinary skills to raise over $20,000, the proceeds of which have gone to furnishing a carer's room in the Alden Complex and the purchase of two stained glass windows in the chapel. Congratulations, Margaret.